farthest reaches of the galaxy come the outer spacemen, Colossus Rex from the giant planet Jupiter, Astronautilus from beneath the seas of Neptune, Alpha 7, the man from Mars, and their interplanetary companions. Seven bendable, flexible figures from outer space, complete with their own fantastic super weapons and detachable space helmets. They're here now at toy stores everywhere. The Outer Spacemen, brought to Earth by Color Forms.
Inviting you in through the squeaking door. I just met a friend of mine. He runs an all-night billiard academy near the cemetery. As after midnight, he uncovers the ghoul tables. But no rough stuff in his place. No, he settles all arguments by arbitration. Simply lifts a shroud and points out they haven't a leg to stand on.
Rocky, why are you doing that? Why are you digging up that grave?
You better not ask so many questions.
Look, if you tell me, I could help you more. You're closed up like a clam. Drive out here to the cemetery. You start digging, you don't shut up.
Hey, I think I found it.
What?
I'll let you know in a minute. As soon as I can open this coffin. Turn that flashlight down here.
Okay.
You want to know why I come here? Take a look in there. You see his right hand? It ain't there.
Queen of Blood. A tantalizing, mystifying enigma.
She's gorged herself with fresh blood.
She's a monster.
We have a good supply of blood plasma with us. We'll use that to feed her.
And if we run out of plasma, Commander?
Comes at midnight. This is the story of how one average family as yours and mine, spent a quiet night at their rented country house. A night of terror. As I said, the Cannings were just an average family. Harry was 29 and worked as a sound engineer for a broadcasting studio in the city. Ethel was 27 and had been a school teacher before she was married. Now she was kept pretty busy between writing the great American novel and taking care of Judy, her 7-year-old daughter.